Welcome back, guys, to another video on the channel. I hope you guys are well. It is the international break, so I'm trying to be a little bit more creative in terms of video ideas for you guys, so you guys are entertained throughout this lockdown period and throughout the international break. Now, guys, for more West Ham content, make sure you drop a like. Make sure to hit the subscribe button. Now, I want to talk about, I was looking at the Premier League table, and I was actually looking at, you know, players that West Ham could potentially sign in the future, maybe in the summer transfer window, even maybe in January, depending on their contractual situation. West Ham could potentially maybe snag a couple of players from potentially relegation-threatened clubs. And before people say, well, why should we sign someone who might be getting relegated? They're not good enough. Well, try telling that to Leicester and Liverpool. Leicester paid £18 million for Hull, for Harry Maguire. Sold him for £80 million. Liverpool signed Andy Robertson for £8 million from Hull, signed Jeannie Wijnaldum for £30 million. Those two players, and even Shaqiri as well from Stoke, but those two players in particular have won the Champions League and the Premier League. So if you can pick the right players, certainly buying players from the league below, from teams that were in the Premier League that have now been relegated, could be a very, very good market strategy. And it is a market strategy. However, let's go into potentially signing number one that I'd like to see West Ham potentially make if a team was to get relegated. Now, let's move to Sheffield United. Sheffield United signed in January last year a player from Ghent called Sander Berg, £20 million, a highly, highly rated youngster. Manchester United were one of those clubs that were looking to grab his signature, and it was actually a surprise that Sheffield United actually managed to pick up his signature for £20 million. I remember looking at the TV on Sky Sports when they actually announced it. A lot of people, Twitter was like, whoa, I can't believe this. This is someone who's got Champions League pedigree. Yes, he was playing in, you know, not so, you know, high standard of a league in Belgium. However, he was playing in Champions League. He is highly rated. So this is someone who's got very, very good qualities. Now, if West Ham were to sign him, what would he bring to the table? Now, he would probably play in a similar mould of Thomas Suchek's position, a CDM box-to-box centre midfielder. However, he is a lot, lot better on the ball than Thomas Suchek. He is someone who's a box-to-box but can also be very disciplined when trying to play a low block against maybe the better teams like Liverpool that we have been doing the last couple of weeks, playing that low block, frustrating and being compact. He could easily play that. However, he's got the legs, he's got the physique, he's got the stamina to do the other side of the game, get into the box. However, he isn't actually that much of a goal scorer. For Genk, he only scored like 6 goals and 4 assists in 100 games, where Thomas Suchek for West Ham, he scored quite a few goals already. So we would maybe lacking that extra threat going forward in the sense of scoring goals. However, this someone is someone who is very leggy, pretty quick for, you know, a big bloke. Sander Berg, and he's someone that we could potentially look at. Now, transfer free wise, they paid £20 million for him. I'd imagine they would want to recoup as much as that as possible, and I'd probably say around about £30 million. However, there could be other potential players. Now, this is moving on to someone who's probably a little bit unrealistic. However, Brighton are not doing very well at the moment in the Premier League. They've got, what, 6 points out of 8 games. And whilst they do play a fantastic style of football, results, it's all about results at the end of the day, especially when you are trying to not get relegated. And Lamptey, someone who, you know, has been spoken about a lot in sort of the English media and is, you know, sort of football fan base. Lamptey, his performances at right wing back for Brighton, who's someone, you know, who can get up and down, someone who's got, who's very good defensively, someone who's very good going forward, very good at scoring goals as well. He's already scored a couple this season. Brighton signed him for £1.5 million or £2 million from Chelsea, which is an absolute bargain. So Brighton play a similar formation, not a similar style of football. They'd like to play a 5-2-3. And whilst they do play the same formation, the style of football that Brighton play and West Ham play are very, very different. They like to play a little bit more possession-based. We like to be sort of more of a counter-attack, quick transitions kind of team. Now, Bayern Munich have been linked with Lamptey. I'm sure Chelsea would probably even look at him. You know, Chelsea may have first refusal on a potential buyback. So if Brighton were to get relegated, for example, would West Ham be a very unlikely, you know, place for him to go? He'd probably be wanted by a lot bigger clubs. As I said, Bayern Munich have already been looking at him. He's someone that's got immense potential, young, English, playing very well in the Premier League, would provide something a little bit different on our right-hand side, especially when we're trying to break down teams such as Fulham. We did see with Soufal that we did struggle maybe to make any advances from that right-hand side. So it would be interesting to see if he was ever to sign him. Would probably cost a lot of money, to be fair, as well. I'm probably talking at least £30 million. For a right back, that is a lot of money in English football. Now, let's move over to Fulham. There's actually two players from Fulham that I really like the look of. Let's start with Areola. Lucas Fabianski has been a fantastic servant for West Ham. However, his time is coming to an end. He's 35, 36 years of age. So whilst at the same time, you could look at it and be like, well, you've probably seen the peak years of Lucas Fabianski. Goalkeepers could potentially play till they're age 40. West Ham do really need to find a number one that could possibly play for the next 3 or 4, 5 seasons. Now, Areola is on loan from PSG at Fulham, having played for Real Madrid as well. This is someone who has got Champions League experience, played for big, big clubs in Paris Saint-Germain and Real Madrid. Now, he is one of those players in that Fulham team who's possibly a shining light in that Fulham team. They haven't made the greatest start to the season, whilst it's probably not a surprise because they did come up from the Championship, winning the playoff final against Brentford. Someone that we could potentially look at to maybe being our number one in the future is Areola. Someone, you know, who's probably going to have good links with maybe Issa Diop because they're both French. You know, French is a very common speaking language in English football. So would probably, you know, speak similar languages and just be a good team cohesion for some of the players. And guess what? And the game that he played against West Ham, he was very, very good in returns of shot stoppers. So could potentially be someone that we could look at. Another player at Fulham that I really like the look of, in a similar mould of Sanderberg, is Anguissa. This is someone that Fulham actually signed 2 years ago from Marseille for about £20 million. He played the season. They got relegated, Fulham. When you remember that season when they spent like £100 million? They got relegated that season. He was loaned back to France, I think. Might have been back to Marseille, but don't quote me on that. And he's come back. And he, again, has been another shining light in that Fulham team. Someone who probably offer some similar characteristics as to what we've got with Thomas Suchek. And then obviously I was talking about Sanderberg. Someone who's physically strong, can easily deal with the physical nature of the Premier League. Someone who can get forward, someone that can defend, someone that can be box to box, but when asked to do, can be disciplined in his role, can sit back. And when we're trying to play the bigger teams and we want to hit the counter attack, maybe be compact and be disciplined in that CDM role. Now, he's actually very skillful. He is actually a very skillful player. I was watching the Leeds game in particular, the Leeds Fulham game, and he, despite Fulham coming out on the wrong end of that result, he was one of their better players. He was probably the best player on the pitch. Very good, skillful. In terms of what kind of player he does remind me of, he does remind me of a little bit like Ndombele at Tottenham. Ndombele is also French, but also he's got that skill. He's a big guy. He's got the physique to cope in the Premier League. So whilst I'm not saying he's as good as him, I'm saying that's what he could potentially bring to West Ham in terms of what kind of player he would be. Now let's move to Burnley, guys. Let's move to Burnley, and he's going to be the final two players for this video. Let's talk about James Tarkowski. Now this is someone that West Ham were linked with in the summer for around about £30 million. Apparently we had a bid of £30 million rejected. Sean Dyche come out and said that it was sort of a fake bid. They didn't really, West Ham didn't really come back to him. They sort of put in a bid in that they knew was going to be rejected, and that was that. No advances after that. And, you know, if Burnley were to get relegated, we understand and we know that it's very well publicised that Burnley are not the greatest in terms of money coming into the club. There's someone that's got a really, really tight budget. Sean Dyche, the amount of times that he's mentioned about, you know, players outgrowing the club, such as Dwight McNeil, such as James Tarkowski, that could potentially leave if the right offer was in. And Burnley, if they was to get relegated, and let's be honest, it could be their season. They are someone that have been punching above their weight for season after season, and will it catch up on them? However, James Tarkowski would be someone who probably be a very good signing. We were linked with him, so it does look like maybe David Moyes likes him. If they were to get relegated, we would probably be looking at probably around about £30 million, considering they would be cash-strapped. Big wages, especially at Burnley, probably on about £50,000 a week. This is someone who's an England international. Whilst, when I say England international, he's played one or two games, and he's probably, you know, come under that. He's probably been tied with the same brush as Dwight McNeil. And the reason why he hasn't had as many England call-ups as he probably should have been is because he's probably considered, because he's at Burnley, he can only play one way, and that is just lump it up to Chris Wood, and that's it. When he actually come from Brentford, a team that are well-known for playing out from the back, and he's had a very good Premier League career, but now could he make that step up? And he's someone that I could potentially look at to sign if Burnley were to get relegated. And I mentioned his name previously, Dwight McNeil. Now, this is someone who's highly rated, but at the same time, he's a little bit criminally underrated. He's got a fantastic left foot. He plays on the left mid, offers fantastic work rate for Burnley. And again, Sean Dyche has come out and said that there will come a time with Dwight McNeil that he will probably have to leave Burnley to accelerate his career, because he is a young guy. He's only like 22, 23 years of age. And offers around about 30 million, I think, have been rejected or have been rumoured to have been rejected from Tottenham in previous summers. So it would be interesting to see if Burnley got relegated, what he would bring to West Ham. Now, as I said, he plays left mid. However, he offers the hard working, you know, work rate, which is something David Moyes is trying to to bring to West Ham, trying to, you know, instill into the team. Work hard for each other, work till the 90th minute. And I've got to say, West Ham right now do look a lot fitter than they've ever done. And that is down to maybe, you know, the backroom staff and the work on the training ground in regards to fitness, working hard for each other. Now, where can I see Dwight McNeil fitting? I could see him being very, very good at left wing back. I'm very surprised with England as well. England are slowly transitioning into a five at the back formation. That he's not actually been considered to play that left wing back position. If someone that can get up and down very quick, is able to beat a man, but has got a fantastic cross on him. And I'm very surprised that England maybe have not considered him for that left wing back position. However, he would be someone who's in direct competition with Arthur Masuaku. Arthur Masuaku's had a fantastic season. But guys, there's nothing like competition. You've seen it so many times throughout the years when goalkeepers or certain players, they get complacent because they know if they have a bad game, they're going to start the next week because there's no competition. And keeping players on their heels is what makes a good team and what makes a team do well. So Dwight McNeil is someone that I would hugely consider, guys. I think that is five players: Sander Berge, Anguissa, Lamptey, James Tarkowski and Dwight McNeil. That is five players that I would potentially look at from possibly relegated clubs, you know, or clubs that could be getting threatened with relegation this season. If I was to look at some players to improve West Ham squad or their style of play, or to players that could probably just slot straight in and improve that starting 11, those are some players that I've just mentioned. Let me know, guys, in the comments section down below. Yes, buying from players is actually a marketing strategy. If you choose the right players, it is very good. As I said, with Liverpool, Andy Robertson, Genie Wijnaldum, two players that played in the champ that, you know, got relegated with their clubs, right? And they've won the Champions League and they've won the Premier League and have been integral players of that formation, that style of play for Jurgen Klopp. Harry Maguire with Leicester, they paid 18 million. He was very good at Leicester. He's gone to Man United, he's not been so good. However, they paid 18 million for him, they sold him for 80. So the potential is there if you select the right players. Guys, for more West Ham content, drop a like, drop a subscription, as it would be greatly appreciated. Let me know in the comment section down below with my choices or you, any players that I missed out. I've only done five because I could probably list about 10. But guys, that is the end of the video. Thank you for watching. Come on, you Irons.